Thank you all so much for being here with us. I'm Hunter Hallowell.
I'm Katie Quigley.
I'm Annie Bulick.
The three of us have spent the last month planning this event. 30 days ago, at this exact moment, Nicholas Cruz had yet to enter Marjorie Stoneman Douglas High School. The 17 lives we are honoring today had yet to be taken. Still, the tragic events of February 14th stimulated the united actions from Americans across the nation that brought all of us here today. So thank you for your unity, a united understanding that our schools need action. American students from all walks of life, from all 50 states, deserve better.
Thank you, Emma Gonzalez, Cameron Caskey, and David Hogg, the leaders of the student-led movement in Parkland, Florida, for providing us with the determination and courage we have standing here today.
No more sitting in a dark closet, waiting for the first shots to be fired.
No more sleepless school nights spent thinking about the tragedy that has been ingrained in our minds as always being right around the corner.
No more kids growing up too fast under the shrill of a gunshot.
There's a reason that this walkout is a month after the shooting at Stoneman Douglas. There's a reason why schools across the nation are planning events focused on this very American issue through the end of the school year. When you refuse to continue the discussion, you refuse to continue taking steps towards lasting, genuine change. And while the American people are busy slowly reverting back to their old, failing ways, the planning and execution of our country's next earth-shattering school shooting goes unnoticed.
This problem will not go away on its own. Rather, without constant and relentless action coming from Americans in all 50 states, it will get worse.
It's bad enough to be a high school student in a time of the normalization of violence in our schools. It's even worse to become so silent and numb to it that it prolongs and gets even worse for further generations.
We hope that what we have planned for our school's walkout leaves you with a better understanding of how you can make your voice heard, in addition to providing a space to respect and remember the 17 lives that were lost 1 month ago today. We'd now like to take the next few minutes to say their names in remembrance of the lives that deserve so much more.
Alyssa Al-Hadef.
Martin Duke Anguiano.
Scott Beagle.
Nicholas Duarette.
Aaron Feiss.
Jamie Gutenberg.
Chris Hickson.
Luke Hoyer.
Kara Loughran.
Gina Montalto.
Joaquin Oliver.
Elena Petty.
Meadow Pollock.
Helena Ramsey.
Alex Schachter.
Carmen Shenchuk.
Peter Wang.
For the remainder of the event, the images and names of many other Americans tragically killed in not only school shootings but mass shootings will be projected to commemorate the lives of so many that were ended because of a lack of action and a lack of change. Their representation in this program allows us to reflect on our nation's past and recognize the problems that we have no choice but to face.
We'd now like to turn your attention to the forensics club.
February 14th. Valentine's Day, a day to celebrate love amongst couples, families, and friends. But now, February 14th will be remembered nationwide as the day that forced students to become national leaders and to speak up for the change they want to see happen in the world. On February 14th, 2018, just 1 month ago today, 17 innocent people, comprised of 14 students, half of them just 14 years old, and three teachers were stripped of their lives in a mass shooting in Parkland, Florida, with countless others injured. We would first like to have a moment of silence for the ones who lost their lives in this tragic event.
The day started out as any other school day would and should. Students attended their classes lingered in the hallways. Little did they know that everything would soon come to a halt. Sometime between 2:21 and 2:28 p.m., the first gunshot rang out. No student or faculty member at Marjory Stoneman Douglas High School has been seen ever since. We're here today because we don't talk about how Parkland, like too many shootings, is feeding into stuff of last month's current events. We're here today because we don't talk about how 40% of all mass shooting victims are suffering from severe PTSD. We're here today because we don't talk about how Peter Wang was 15 years old when he died, holding the door open so his classmates could escape gunfire. We're here today not to rally, but to remember. And through this process of healing, students are taking action and bringing attention to the need for stronger security. Let us consider Emma Gonzalez, a 19-year-old senior at Douglas High who expertly exemplifies the definition of empowering. Gonzalez recently spoke at the anti-gun rally in Florida and is working to have stricter gun laws passed. But we must realize this is also a moral conflict, where we, as students and teachers, must decide what course of action to take, or to take any at all. Gonzalez put it perfectly when she said, "We are speaking up for those who don't have anyone listening for them, for those who can't talk about it just yet, and for those who will never speak again. We are grieving, we are furious, and we are using our words fiercely and desperately because that's the only thing standing between us and this happening again." This issue is about the ethics of school safety, about ensuring the Parkland massacre is the last school massacre this country ever endures.
But what defines a school massacre? The world has often misused and trivialized this term. It is paramount to understand what the word massacre truly means in this context. According to Everytown, a very reliable movement focusing on gun safety, states that in 2018 alone, there have already been 17 mass shootings. Four of these meet the definition that at least one victim was injured or killed. One of the victims was a student or teacher, and the event took place on school property. Since 2013, 63 school shootings have met this definition, with 6 adults and 35 children killed, and 12 adults and 92 children injured. Clearly, it is more apparent that now is the time to be heard, more than any other time in our nation's history. By attending this walkout, you've already taken the first step in recognizing that we have a serious moral issue on our hands, and that nationwide, school safety needs to be reformed.
So what's the next step? You can attend the March for Our Lives event on March 24th, which is a movement to highlight that school safety is a priority. If you can't make it all the way to Washington, D.C. or New York City for the day, there's an even easier way for you to get involved. You can sign your name on posters located in the classrooms of Mrs. Broffman in 512, Mrs. Callahan in 501, Mrs. Kyle in 505, and Ms. Rahm in 403. Each of these teachers is bringing a poster signed by JCHS students to the march in Washington, D.C., and you will be represented in this way. Also, I will be attending the march in Washington, D.C., so if you wanted to talk about it with me, feel free to do that. And if you can't make it to Washington, D.C. or New York City, there are marches in New Jersey, in Morristown, in Newark, and also Montclair. And other ways to show your support for this issue include simply using the hashtag #NeverAgain on any form of social media, or visiting websites of organizations who focus on gun violence, like everytown.org and also marchforourlives.com.
As a final thought, it is important that you stay informed about the issues surrounding school safety, know what the reforms our government representatives are implementing, and understand what reforms they are rejecting. If you are pleased with the steps they are taking, let them know it. If you are disappointed or angry with their decisions, you must let your voice be heard. It's the only way change will come. Thank you for being a part of this walkout today. On a larger scale, thank you for being a part of an empowering student-led movement, which is only just the beginning of the amazing reforms that are to come.
To close out the walkout, we'd like to welcome the JCHS Madrigals to the stage to deliver a message of positive reflection. Once they have finished, we invite you to head back to class, hopefully ready to take action, create change, and commit to a safer school environment.
What'd you think? Did I make you proud?